Okay. I could have done it, but I said, fuck it, kid. Swish. Not quite a swish, but I did the ditch.
As a co-equal branch of government.
Yeah,
know, the balance is completely out of whack now, Lou, and it is very dangerous, especially given this.
Why doesn't anybody talk about it? Why doesn't anybody talk about it, John? I mean, it's staring us in the face. We have not an imperial. We have an imperious imperial presidency that has unchecked powers, with the possible exception of the Supreme Court, which right now is at least delayed. An executive fiat against the deportation that had stopped the deportation of as many as 5 million illegal immigrants, but that is just simply held in abeyance. It's not resolved.
Yeah, and unfortunately, the Supreme Court is not, of course, not an elected branch of government.
Right.
We've got a Congress that is supposed to be a co-equal branch of government that has a serious oversight role over administration efforts to act that are contrary to the Constitution, including in foreign affairs, and it's just not playing that role at the moment.
And what role will this government, whether the executive or to bring along Congress, what will it do in response to the provocations of Russia, China, whether we're talking about the Black Sea, the Baltic, whether we're talking about the South China Sea, or whether we're talking about, suddenly the appearance on the part of Iran that they are moving straight ahead with the development of a nuclear bomb, despite the release by this administration of $150 billion to them.
And don't forget to add to that, Lou, the fact that we had a fifth North Korean nuclear test today. Not to mention last week they fired off three more medium-range ballistic missiles. This has been an awful week for U.S. interests. Just underscores how weak and feckless they see this lame duck administration being. They're going to continue to.
Let's go take a lead right here, baby. 3, 2. Just a second. Okay. Life was on the down. Thank you.
last week, I just called a friend of mine, Dr. Robert Heisinger,